So I review lots of lasers here on the channel, and there is one question I get more than anything else across all my videos, and that is, can this laser engrave metal? And the answer has always been no, until this week. All right, guys, welcome back to the shop. My name is Brandon, and we're gonna be taking a look at this 20-watt fiber laser from Ohmtech. You might have seen something kind of like this before if you've ever looked for fiber lasers. These are typically the Chinese import type, which means they're a lot less expensive. You don't get the support that comes with a higher cost machine. That's why lately I've been recommending Ohmtech, because they're a US-based supplier of not only fiber lasers, but also CO2 lasers. In full transparency, they sent me this at a discount so that I could do a review for you guys. And if you go through any of the links down below, as always, they are affiliate links. We're gonna compare this to a CO2 laser. These are like the K40 that are super popular. Also, there are larger 50-watt, 60-watt, 100-watt CO2 lasers. On the desktop side of things, the real popular ones are like Glowforge or Full Spectrum Muse, but this is an entirely different beast, and it is for two main reasons that we're gonna get into. First is with how the laser is actually created, and second is how the laser is actually directed onto your workpiece. So this is the unit that's actually generating the laser beam, and it's actually using a whole bunch of diode lasers, which this is a very big diode laser that you might have seen on other machines that are reviewed in the past. And these typically will go onto a CNC type machine that can move this thing around, and that is how you actually engrave something. Now, this is compared to a CO2 laser, which has a big glass tube in the back. And then again, there is a gantry, but instead of the actual laser being attached to it, it is getting reflected through mirrors, and then it is focused right at the end of the gantry. So both diodes and CO2 lasers are using stepper motors and a typical gantry setup. So you're really limited by the speed of those stepper motors. Now, the best that I understand, a fiber laser is using a bunch of these diode lasers. This is actually focused through a fiber tube, which is this guy right here on the back. Then it comes into this guy, which then focuses the beam down into your piece. And if you guys are wondering right now what this red guy is, this is just like a laser pointer. So that's why I'm touching it and doing totally fine. The actual laser is different. But that gets us a dot in the middle. How does this actually move? So a galvo laser actually uses a galvanometer right here, which is basically just a series of mirrors that then focus the beam in different directions. So instead of having a big XY gantry that actually moves either the diode or the focused laser beam from a CO2 laser, the laser beam is actually moved right here and directed to different spots on your material. Now, what does it actually mean for you guys? This thing is really, really fast. In fact, this is how long it took to engrave this guy. And actually, in the software, I now have it running just continuously, just so you can kind of see how it engraves. But at the very beginning, I mean, it took, what, a couple seconds, if that, to engrave this thing. So it is very, very quick. And kind of the downside of fiber systems versus a CO2 or even a diode is that at the edges of where it's reflected, you won't get as clean of a cut, because since you have the gantry, you're always getting it completely focused right at the spot. But with this, when you get kind of to the outskirts, you potentially could have some fall off, and it's not gonna be quite as focused. But if you're doing smaller stuff and you're wanting to mark it, this is a great option. Now, because this is a fiber source, that basically means the frequency of the laser is different, as you're able to engrave as well as cut metal. Now, this 20-watt unit isn't really for cutting metal. They say you can do some really, really thin sheet metal stuff, but you're gonna mostly use this for engraving. So that's how it works, but let's actually go through this unit and specifically what it actually is. So you've got the controller that basically has all the electronics. How the actual light beam is generated is right here. Then all that comes through this tube out to this laser head. And then you've got this unit, which is a big stand that is housing the actual galvanometer that's focusing your laser beam. This is nice because you can basically turn this up and down, and this helps you focus the laser. So real easy, and it has marks here up the side. And this work bay comes with these rails that you can screw in. So if you are batching out a ton of parts that are the same size, then you can drop them in and run the part over and over and over again. In fact, that is a really common use case for these lasers, and this actually comes with a foot switch. So you can hit the switch, engrave real quick, drop in the next part, hit the switch, engrave real quick. And if you're numbering things, the software comes with the ability where it'll automatically kind of count up or count however you want it. So you can batch out parts really quick. Speaking of software, you use EasyCAD to run it, which is specific for these type of lasers. So for my CO2 and diode lasers, I typically use Lightburn unless it has its own software, like with the Glowforge or Full Spectrum. But EasyCAD has a lot more features that are specifically for these types of machines. Now, we aren't gonna really get into the software in this video. I'm gonna do a follow-up to kind of show a lot more examples of how everything works. But just know it works great, although it does take a little bit to learn. Now, in terms of the capabilities, this is a 200 by 200 millimeter work area, which I might be able to show you. So a nice feature in the software, it can give you a preview of what it's about to do. So I actually just put in a 200 by 200 millimeter square, so you can kind of see what the work area is gonna look like. Again, the power on this guy is 20 watts, and this is actually on the low end of the ones that Ohmtech provides. This comes with a frequency range of 20 to 100 kilohertz. We really won't get into frequency stuff with this, but just know it's another variable like speed and power that you can use to affect how this actually performs on the different materials that you're using. And just like a super random fact is it comes with safety glasses, and I do have to say these are the nicest ones that I've gotten for any of my lasers. And even though these are super cheap, especially compared to the actual laser, it's nice to have a good pair. So on the cutting side of things, I haven't tested this specifically, although they do say you can cut up to 0.079, which is really thin on sheet metal, but you can engrave a lot of things. So you can pretty much do any type of steel, stainless steel, copper, bronze, gold, silver, all that kind of stuff. You can also do stone, tile, titanium, and even tungsten, but you can't do wood, or it really isn't optimized for wood. So if you guys are still wanting to do wood stuff, check out my other reviews on diode lasers and then CO2 lasers. So overall, it is fairly easy to use. The only real thing you have to dial in at the beginning is the focus. And what I've seen other people do is basically make a small square that is filled in with a hatch, and then you run it continuously, and then you spin this up and down, and you kind of listen and watch. And when you see it spark the most, as well as you hear it the loudest, you basically know that you are focused. And you can use the scale to see the distance that you are above the material. So again, this is coming from Ohmtech. So they have manufactured in China, but then they import them directly. So a nice part about that is you also get customer service, which if you've ever bought one of the Chinese imports from Alibaba or eBay, you know you're pretty much shooting in the dark. And if you have an issue, you're just gonna have to figure it out yourself. But with them, you can actually have somebody and you could talk to them. So I'm gonna show you just a couple of tests. First, we're gonna take a look at text. And you can see you can both just outline the text or you can fill it in. There's different hatch settings. And what's also nice is you can really get the text small. You can actually see this is like the start of the Emancipation Proclamation, and it is tiny on this little piece of stainless steel. So you can do the text directly in the software. You can also do barcodes. That's something that will generate for you itself. And then you can do barcodes directly on your material. A lot of people will use these type of machines to put numbers on parts. And it's got a feature in the software where after you engrave one, it will automatically count up. So if you're batching a bunch of different parts and you wanna put numbers on it, or you wanna put your logo with a number on it, it has some really cool automated ways where you can really knock those out very quickly. So another cool thing about this is you can actually import bitmap images and engrave it. And something I've always wanted to try is to get something that kind of looks like Beskar steel, which is basically this cool looking metal block from The Mandalorian. Now, I've seen people 3D print this, I've seen people paint it and give you an effect, but since it's metal, let's actually use this guy. While we are engraving, I wanna let you know that this video is sponsored by Skillshare. And if you're looking at any type of laser, your next step is gonna figure out what type of artwork you wanna bring in. And maybe you get tired of looking for vector art online, so you can import it directly into Lightburn or into EasyCAD with this guy. And you're looking to step it up and actually learn some vector editing software. I personally use Adobe Illustrator to do a lot of my stuff. And I recently went through this class from DKNG Studios that walks you through a lot of good tips to speed up your workflow. But Skillshare actually has tons of classes. You can learn not only vector art, but also how to manipulate photos inside of Photoshop, as well as a bunch of other things. And right now they've got a deal going where the first 1,000 people that use my link down below will get a 1 month free of Skillshare Premium. I encourage you guys to jump in, check it out. There's a lot of really cool courses inside. You can see it's actually pretty small. I didn't want to spend forever engraving it. And you're able to import an image. You can play around with the contrast and the brightness settings, and then it can do dithering, which basically makes it a bunch of tiny little dots that then lets the laser actually engrave it and give you the effect that you have different shades of gray. Now, just like with diode lasers or CO2 lasers, you'll need to test it a good bit. And linked down below are a few test files that I ran across that you can bring directly into EasyCAD. And so there is a power versus a speed file, but then there's also a power versus frequency. Again, remember, frequency is another of those variables that we can change. And a good way to think about frequency is basically how many tiny little laser pulses it does per second. So a lower frequency setting means it's gonna distribute that same constant power over less of those pulses. So each one of those is gonna be stronger. So as you ramp that up, then it gets less and less. And then just a goofy way I've thought about it is kind of like with boxing, you've got one guy who can punch a lot and really quick, so like a high frequency, but those punches aren't going to be as strong versus like a heavyweight Mike Tyson who's just going to uppercut you and knock you out with one punch. And that's with a lower frequency, which is a goofy example, but that works for me. Now, what's cool about the frequency is you start to get some pretty interesting effects on metal because it's going to oxidize and it's actually not just going to give you different shades of gray, but you're actually going to start to get colors. Now, again, I would run these files on any type of material that you plan on doing. So you kind of see what is the best effect for what you're looking for. Maybe you want something really dark in the metal, or maybe you like the fact that actually it looks a little bit more polished, and so it's actually lighter when the laser goes through it. But on this piece of steel, you can actually see there's a lot of blue in the sky, and even before there was a hint of red. And then here are the same tests, but on a sheet of aluminum. Again, you can see there's a hint of blue on this one, not quite as with the steel, but you can especially see how you can basically almost get white on aluminum depending on your settings. Now for the stat that you've already probably looked at because you clicked the link is how much this guy costs. At the time of this recording, it's right at $2,900. So again, this is a good deal more expensive than the 40 watt CO2 machine that I've reviewed in the past, and even getting into the range of some of the nicer desktop units. Now there's a smaller version of this that actually has everything all in one piece that's less expensive, but the actual work area is going to be smaller as a result. So who is a machine like this for? So first off, on the price side of things, you're probably not gonna get this just to play around with it unless you really, really want to be able to mark metal. But I would definitely recommend getting one of these if you are doing something and selling it. We can make little necklace pendants and engrave them, or dog tags or all that kind of stuff. Or if you're more on the practical side and you're wanting to put barcodes or QR codes or part numbers directly on metal tools. Now this also does a really good job with powder coated or anodized metals. So even though you could do those with a laser because you're basically removing the top layer, this guy not only removes the top layer but also engraves underneath. And I'm finding that I actually get a little bit better results with it. You can also get a rotary, so you can do like metal tumblers or anything that is circular, and you can put logos and text and all that kind of stuff on top of it. Let me know down in the comments if there's something you want me to take a look at, maybe a specific application you had in mind, or if there's just a cool project you think would be fun to try on something that can engrave metal. Maybe you've got to this point and you realized a metal laser really isn't for you, but you're interested in a CO2 laser to be able to do stuff specifically with wood. We're going to jump to my review of the 40 watt unit from Ohmtech that can do just that. So until next time, go make or break something in your shop. See you guys.